At first glance, you may say his life on the streets is a result of a lack of determination and drive. But could you walk away from a full-time job as a construction worker to follow your heart, to sit by the street side doing what you love best? And while most of us may dismiss him as crazy, nothing could be further from the truth. 34-year-old Michael Gordon dropped out of school in Standard 6 for financial reasons. All through those early childhood years, Gordon was drawn to drawing and painting. Now he may not have his works displayed on the walls of Belize's banks and major business offices, like Belize's premier artists Caetano and Gab. Instead, they humbly lean against the wall outside of the Prince Albert store. At the risk of being criticized for wasting my time, I took a walk out to the corner of Albert and Prince Streets and made a new friend. Meet Michael Gordon, the street artist.
In a drawing, in a painting, right? Things like that. Then I really like you to take on camera, snap same way and get direct things at the same time, right? You see, you have to just take your time, you know, increase that certain touch, you know, put it there, right? Maybe some people have the talent to really bring it right to that point at the same time, but I don't really have it, right? So why, I don't know, you know, I do amount so far like that, right? And I go back and I do it a little bit farther again.
And to take his art further, he sits out in the hot sun creating and improving his pencil and ink creations, created not on canvas, but on discarded paper and cardboard. To my surprise, while sitting with him, he actually made a sale.
20 for both.
That's all right, it. All right.
Say no more.
You see, to have something now, the best thing is share it, right? And if you take a mountain, just give all away, you know, then you're not going to have nothing to make no more, right? So I feel like, you know, just put only change to whatever you like to, you know. Well, I have out just set out now. I don't really to say, well, you know, not a perfect picture, snapper, someone, right? But, you know, timely. You know, you have an amount of coloring on it, right? You got an amount of turns on it that people could come and say, you know, they could drop some money and really, you know, give something, right? To get something, cause, you know.
But something Gordon finds hard to do is describing his work to viewers.
That the only one step of the cheekbone, this cheekbone where my try sell. See, after and I done crayon over the face, right? Could finish that and then maybe put whiskers if I like to, you know, and put, you know, beard and things like that. That two guy there, you know, two human. This one is bigger than that one there, you know, right? I went out and sat so close, you know, like in a wall that, you know, one understand, but he cannot tell the next one what he understand because, you know, he wish to tell him something, you know, like a strange eclipse in your life that you really cannot, you cannot explain, you know, you only have to use your own self-control and to make your life, you know, live upon earth.
One person who has seen his work and was impressed was artist and poet Yasser Musa. Musa thinks that Gordon is one of Belize's most important artists and indeed proves that all humans have the talent to create.
Well, I think it's a profound set of things operating. For one, I think he has his own vocabulary, which I as an artist strive to gain, but I am so corrupted by Western civilization that I sort of become handicapped by what is out there and the knowledge of what I know. And he has a sort of very unique style, his very own. That's Michael Gordon. Whenever you look at any one of his drawings, you see that he has created them. And they're also profound by the deranged nature of the work. And I'm not saying deranged in a negative way, I'm saying it hits you immediately. It has a very powerful impact. Now, a lot of people might dismiss it as something in bad taste, no? But of course, most people in Belize have plastic flowers in their house, so there's nothing more worse than that as bad taste. So.
Even though his art may be the most widely viewed, as we pass it daily going about our business on Albert Street, Gordon has not achieved the status and recognition other artists have. But this does not prevent him from having an opinion about art in Belize.
Many people, you know, just come and say, well, you know, you must check with this one and check with that one then, you know. You know, I find if I go through the process, go after people like that, you know, people are fine, like, you know, I would have, a weakness that they themselves cannot solve, see? So then I gonna be a problem to them, see? In here, they're just a better man win, right? Because then, you know, if you really judge somebody, you know, you're gonna be wrong, right? Then you're gonna find yourself in a default, you know, that could really maybe gonna carry up, but then, you know, in yourself, you're gonna be down.
But whether his art ends up on the walls of galleries or in the homes of collectors, one thing is for sure, Michael Gordon will keep coming out to Albert Street, showing the Belizean public that as long as one wants to create, where there is a will, there is a way. Daedra Isaacs for News 5.